పత్రి సార్కి, ఠాకూర్ సార్కి, నన్ను గైడ్ చేసిన మాస్టర్స్ అందరికీ ఆత్మప్రణామములు. ఈరోజు మనం స్వాధ్యాయ గ్రూప్ లో చర్చించుకునే అంశం ది క్రియేటివ్ సౌండ్ సాక్రెడ్ మ్యూజిక్ డ్యాన్స్ అండ్ సాంగ్ బై ఠాకూర్ సెరాయ్ డారియల్. కంటెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బుక్ ఆర్ అన్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ విత్ ఠాకూర్ సెరాయ్ డారియల్. One, foundations of creativity. Second, music and song. How I compose music. Third one. Fourth one, creativity of the musical mind. Fifth one, music and ideas. Sixth, rhythm and centers. Seventh, rhythm and matter. Eighth, mystery of rhythm. Nine, four types of music. Music in the future. 11. Tool of transformation. 12. Composers. 13. The source of music. 14. Rhythmic living. 15. Music of space. 16. Art and music. 17. My music teacher. 18. Temple dances. 19. Dances of giving chords. 20. Creativity and dance. 21. Temple dances and music. 22nd, the dance of labor. 23rd, the language of dance. 24th, preparation for dance. 25th, practicing movements. 26th, breaking patterns. 27th, the origin of temple dances. 28th, temple dances and patterns. 29th, dance of the seven rays. 30th, why singing. 31st, how to sing. 32nd, sound and voice. 33rd, the mystery of hearing. 34th, ceremonies, rituals and sacraments in the future. Okay friends, first nenu ee topic enchukodaniki mukhya karanam sir classes teeskomannapudu nenu ee topic gurinchi class teeskovalani aalochistunnapudu నాకు ఒక డ్రీమ్ గుర్తొచ్చిందండి. ఆ డ్రీమ్ లో ఈ 5 మంత్స్ నుండి మనము అంటే చాలా ఫియర్ఫుల్ గా ఉన్నాం కదా ఈ సిచ్యుయేషన్స్ కి. అప్పుడు నా డ్రీమ్ లో ఏమొచ్చిందంటే ఆకాశం మొత్తము సాక్రెడ్ మ్యూజిక్ తో నిండిపోయినట్లు. అప్పుడు మొత్తము అందరూ ఆ మ్యూజిక్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత అందరు జాయ్ఫుల్ గా హ్యాపీగా ఉన్నారనమాట. ఆ మ్యూజిక్ హీల్ చేసింది అని నాకు ఒక డ్రీమ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ వచ్చింది. అప్పుడు నేను ఈ బుక్ చదివాను. ఆ డ్రీమ్ కి ఈ బుక్ కి నాకు చాలా సూట్ అయింది అనిపించింది. అందుకే నేను ఈ టాపిక్ తీసుకున్నాను. దీంట్లో ఠాకూర్ సార్ ఒక మెసేజ్, ఒక ఇంటర్వ్యూలో ఒక మెసేజ్ ఇస్తారు, అది ఇంకా నన్ను చాలా ఈ టాపిక్ చెప్పాలి అని డిసైడ్ చేసుకునేందుకు కారణమైంది. ఏంటంటే, once you decide to live for the service of light, love, beauty, my music will take you on its wings and lead your spiritual destination. Once you decide to live for the service of light, love, beauty, my music will take you on its wings and lead your spiritual destination. First chapter, an interview with ठाकूर सेराय डारियल. ठाकूर सेराय डारियल was born into a musical family. His mother was an organist and pianist. His sisters were violinists. And his father was a composer and a conductor of small orchestra. ठाकूर was raised in an atmosphere of music and creativity. He attended almost all rehearsals of his father's orchestra. చిన్నతనం నుండే ఠాకూర్ మ్యూజిక్ ఫ్యామిలీలో పుట్టడం వల్ల మ్యూజిక్ యొక్క పవర్ ఏంటి, అది మన డే టు డే లైఫ్ సిచ్యువేషన్స్కి ఎట్లా ఉపయోగపడుతుంది, మ్యూజిక్ మనకి ఎలా పనిచేస్తుంది అనే టాపిక్స్ నేను ఈరోజు చూస్ చేసుకున్నాను. దాంట్లో ఒక ఇంటర్వ్యూలో ఒక క్వశ్చన్ ఉంటుంది, హౌ డు యూ కంపోజ్. ఠాకూర్ సెరాయ్ డారియల్ ఆన్సర్, My compositions are the translations of moments of inner experiences, states of consciousness, visualization, and identification with some of my life's dreams. During my composing, I try to use the notes as if they were colors in the air, with their specific shapes and hues. For example, I may create a rose in the air with the flow of the sound. My visualization is translated into notes to build the rose exactly as I see it in my vision. Every piece for me is a formation of architectural and natural forms. If music cannot be built by vision, then there is something wrong within it. I also create different scenarios. For example, I visualize high mountains, the moon, snow falling, and a little hut with a boy sitting near a fire. I visualize inner states of consciousness and I create music corresponding to such states. I generally receive my inspiration from inner states of consciousness or from outer events or scenarios that present some symbolic form of my inner states of beingness. For example, a river, a creek, a lake with birds, a waterfall, bamboo or flowers are for me the symbolic manifestation of my inner states of beingness. What are the things that inspire you most in your composing? Question. Answer. I receive great inspiration from things, flowers, oceans, lakes, canyons. In short, from nature, I receive inspiration from artworks, such as the paintings of Nicholas Roerich and poetry of Rabindranath Tagore. I also receive inspiration from a fairy tales and legends and from those people who try to demonstrate a sacrificial life. I want my music to reveal those states that words cannot express. For me, music is intuitional conversation, which tells me more about reality than any other symbol of word does. Composers talk through music. It is strange to note that some of them start sentences and not finish them. Some repeat their off sentences without making any sense. Some start talking and then suddenly change the course of their talk and jump from the one subject to another. There are only a few who know how to talk and make sense from the beginning to the end with emotion, thought, and vision. Of course, there are many greats in talk. Some talk for the past, some for the present, some for the future. There are also those who speak like babies, only a few words and short sentences. Advanced composers talk to your heart, soul, and mind simultaneously. And the speech evokes all the beauty that is hidden within you. Question. How would you explain the effect of music upon others? If the music is of a high quality, it affects people as a fragrance does. It also purifies the space and establishes harmony. It may also heal on all levels. I remember the words my father once said to a group of musicians. Good music heals all your ills and makes you able to discover treasures within yourself. Question. About the music you have composed, how should we utilize it? Answer. Without attachment, I recommended that you listen to my music. It is the only sounds purposefully created to destroy your crystallizations. If you have any crystallization physically, emotionally, and mentally, listen to this music 1 hour daily and 1 week. Later, you will not have those crystallizations. This music might initially bug you. Many people don't like it because their crystallizations fight against it. But give it 1 week and see what is happening to your consciousness. Sit quietly and listen to it. This way, it penetrates into your aura, into your etheric, astral, and mental bodies. Don't listen to it while going to sleep. This would be hypnotic. Just read the commentaries on the songs. Then listen to the music. If you are sincerely listening, 1 week later, you will want to listen to it more. This music will purify your whole system if you do hard labor to change yourself in the meantime. A university professor once wrote, I heard your obnoxious music and put it away. But later when I was divorcing my wife, I was looking for some music and your tape popped out. I listened to it into the early morning hours, crying as I listened. When I was finished, my consciousness was very expanded and beautiful. I went directly to my wife and asked her to listen to this music with me. We are now back together. This music creates transformation. My music is very powerful means to destroy crystallizations in your aura. Etheric, astral, and mental crystallizations. Once your crystallizations are broken and dispersed from your aura, you have a great chance to build new behaviors, new kinds of responses, and new ways of thinking. You must listen to the music in a very relaxed and focused way, absorbing every move of it with the intention to transform yourself. Until you are able to memorize it, you must not be passive but conscious and awake while you are listening. It is very important to understand that if you listen to this music while you want to keep your negative emotions in your heart, your hidden motives in your mind and your jealousy in your bones, the music will amplify them and bring them to the surface. Many people turn into traitors and others fall into the paths of crime and slander. This is similar to feeding yourself with utilizing food and taking vitamins. You use the energy for what you are. You stimulate your vices if you have them and you become the victim of your vices. It is important that people don't overcharge themselves through meditation, reading, listening to my music, or eating extra food before they have a pure heart to use the energy for worthy purpose. Increasing the supply of energy works in positive or negative ways. People don't understand the benefit from highly charged music. They must have clean motives and life directions. Chapter 2, Music and Sound. Sound is the source of all that exists in the universe. Each atom, each form on any level is composed of sound. The ageless wisdom teaches that all communication between created forms is based on sound. Sound that is audible and sound that is inaudible. Sound manifests also as light and as energy. Sound manifests also as light and as energy. Sound initially radiated 7 energy currents, which are called the 7 rays. Each ray is a note. Each note or ray creates a plan. We are told that the continuity of sound brought into existence 7 cosmic planes. Each plane is becoming an octave with 7 notes. Wounds caused by acting against the natural laws accumulate life after life, complicating the health situation of person not only on the physical plane but also on the emotional and mental planes. Throughout ages, people tried to heal the human being with many methods, with success and failure. Nature has not yet revealed the real method by which eventually all diseases will be healed, starting from the mental plane to astral, etheric and physical planes. The secret of healing exists in sound, and nature releases sound at various times that brings massive healing to people. For example, we have the sound of winds, hurricanes, tornadoes, the sound of ocean waves, the roar of volcanoes, the sound of massive fires, the sound of earthquakes, the sound of various kinds of natural destruction, the sound of waterfalls, rivers, creeks, rainfalls, the sounds of natural explosions such as thunder, the sounds of animal, birds, leaves, bushes, trees. If a scientific study is done about natural sound, it is very probable that scientists will destroy the healing effects of sound on human ailments. The vegetable kingdom and the animal kingdom are equipped with the ears that surpass the capacity of the physical ear of the human kingdom. If enough study is carried out on the relations of this kingdom to the sounds of nature, it will be revealed that the vegetable and animal kingdom are controlled and related to each other by special ultrasonic and infrasonic currents. Big animals like elephants and others use ultrasonic sound to converse with each other over as much as 1,000 miles of distance. But the most important point is that they follow the guidance of nature in receiving nature's direction expressed through various sounds. Also, they help themselves by carrying their bodies close to the source of those sounds that have special characteristics to heal them. A horse not only responds to natural sounds by its own sound, but it also has ultrasonic communication with nature. A horse even hears the sound of human emotion and human thought. Those who have experience with horses may understand that horses feel their emotions and hear the sound of their thoughts. All existence lives, moves, and exists in an ocean of sound. The ageless wisdom says that Om is the sound which sustains the existence of the universe. If Om stops sounding in space, the whole existence will disappear as a shadow. The treasury lies in natural sounds and their scientific effect on human psychology, the physical body, even in the human spiritual orientation. In the future, scientific research will be carried out to prove that various nations, even states or groups, are shaped by the sound prevalent in their area. Creativity of the musical mind, fourth chapter. Music has many sides. The first two are contact and translation. Contact is the outer impact to your ears and brain. This can be pleasant or unpleasant according to the conditions of the etheric centers. But by translation, you can control the negative impact or enrich the positive impact. For example, for 1 hour, you hear the drum and you think this is boring, this is giving me a headache. But when you use your creative imagination and visualize a dance to the rhythm of the drum, the negativity disappears because of your translation. You not only create a dance, but also a melody and music by using different notes between the beats or the intervals of the beats. Music also an outer force, which is the force of the musician, his body, his throat, etc. Reading the notes and playing the music add another dimension to the music. The spirit you put into the music is also dimension. The spirit is your dream, vision, enthusiasm, love, joy, and compassion. When music played with its own notes and this inner dynamics are added, it is a different piece of music. Every genius musician plays his music or sings for the sake of the music. In order to give a spiritual message to humanity, he never worries about the money, but money pours in. If he turns greedy because of the money, you can see the decline of his art. Those who say the musicians don't make money prove that they were not musicians sent with a message to air. Such people are merchants who create music only if they are paid. Usually such people don't succeed. There is something divine in music, but you can betray the divinity in music. Music is just like the arju of worship, arju to worship. It is there to create devotion, dedication, sublimity, and transformation. The music that does not serve its ideal is a prostituted music, which can contaminate millions and bring in a degeneration. Of course, to live in the true standards of music needs courage, daring, and long years of preparation. Impact in other factor in music, it can be dealt with in four phases. There is a physical impact in which your physical body is in rhythm and harmony with the music, and you even have involuntary moments that bring you pleasure. There is an emotional impact which emotionally moves you. You are excited, you cry, you fall into many kinds of moods. Exaltation, depression, or imaginations. Third, there is a mental impact which makes you think, visualize, plan. It is very interesting that when the impact is mental, the mental body plans for the future or digs into past events. Fourth one, above these three impacts, there may be a spiritual impact, which is transformational impact. Because of the music, you leave behind certain things in your character and aspire new virtues. Sometimes your whole character is transformed in the music. When it hits your spiritual nature, the human soul or the intuition, many great decisions are taken and new ways of creativity are found under the spiritual impact of the music. Such music must originate from self-actualized people, not from merchants of music, in order to affect your spiritual nature. And you must be advanced enough to receive such an impact. Many musicians play the music with the force generated by their physical body. Others play exactly what the notes say. This is a mechanical way of rendering the music. Others translate the notes into their emotions, their thoughts, their dreams, and visions. or they translate it through their future aspirations. In the ageless wisdom, we are told, we must remember, I thought this was an exoteric order, that we must remember the wisdom given by our teachers, books, events, etc. Then one day I had an experience. A light hit my mind and disappeared instantaneously. I asked, what was the idea, that impression? It was so quick. I noticed that it was an impact which I must remember. So I went into deep contemplation for a few hours and I remembered. As I remembered, it unfolded into a book, a one second impact of the ray of light turned into a book, unfolding chapter after chapter in logical sequence. Such moments come like falling stars, but they are within you. Remember them, bring them out into your consciousness. Remember the seconds when you are caught in one moment of beauty, transformation, and dig them out. Don't let them go. They are messages from the higher worlds. If you start remembering, you will establish contact with the sources and enrich your life. After that, you will be able to remember yourself. Most of us remember world or life events. We are nothing but bodies, emotions, thoughts. Not that deeper awareness, you need that is the core of our being. When you remember every moment that you are the self, then you will start walking the path of immortality. Real music is the result of remembering the impressions and impacts given to you by higher worlds. Fifth chapter, music and ideas. Music is the manifestation of an idea through song. We can receive an idea when we contact higher sources of inspiration within us. On the planet or in space, an idea is relative to the source. The higher the source, the greater the idea. When you are register an idea and visualize a way to manifest it through sound, you create music. It is the idea that creates the melody, rhythm, harmony, and so on. Many pieces of music don't have an idea behind them. If there is no idea in the succession of sound, there exists no music, but only noise. In the same way, there can be a combination of words, but with no idea, there is no sentence and no meaning. The origin of music must be an idea. For example, let us say you are inspired by the idea of renunciation. You visualize the progressive movement and unfoldment of the idea. You feel and sense each phase of it. Then you create its vehicles of manifestation through song. Thus, the idea creates or evokes mental response, emotional response, and sensory response. If the composer is really inspired with the idea, feels it, and fuses it with his aspiration and thoughts, you will hear the idea in the music. Not only will you hear the idea, but you will feel that. For example, the music on renunciation is awakening a deep aspiration in you toward renunciation. And you are going through a certain confirmation within your vehicles that will enable you bring the idea of renunciation into actualization. The idea is coming from higher sources. It is charged by tremendous amount of energy with its own frequency and direction. music in the future. It is hoped that the near future, within 100 years, the adepts of music will come into incarnation to use song and music as a service for humanity. To alleviate physical, emotional, and mental pain and suffering, and to start the age of Aquarius. This music will be the combination of science, inspiration, and impression. The composers, according to the need of the individual group and nation, will prepare specific pieces to meet the specific need. In the future, it will not be a surprise if your physician prescribes a piece of music to heal your indigestion or wipe out your headache. The purpose of music of the future is to do the following. First one, invigorate the cells and organs in the vehicles of man. Create integration and health. Stimulate the glands and chakras through expanding the consciousness. Second, eradicate disorders and attacks to the body, emotions, and mental nature. Protect the vehicles of man from attacks of germs and hostile virus in nature. Provide sunshine and food for the chakras to bloom in harmonious ways. Stimulate sensitivity in the emotion and clarity and sharpness in the mind. Increase striving and labor for perfection. Encourage heroic acts, fearlessness, and daring. Create a breakthrough between the visible and the subtle worlds. Enable man to have contact with his heart and conscience, and to reveal the sense of responsibility. Cause the blooming of his chalas. Realize the brotherhood of humanity. Realize one's own divinity. Develop forgiveness, gratitude, and bliss. Man can help nature to recover, but he must not attempt to change its course. We have already induced enough damage to forests, oceans, space, rivers through our wars, poisonous gases, radioactivity, and toxins. It is a miracle that such an abusive mother still provides nourishment and comfort to her children. In the future, it will be possible to heal and restore nature and slowly eliminate causes that deeply damage it by using scientifically and inspirationally created music. Humanity is advancing with grand steps in the science of computers and multi-cult space sciences. But the main key in the sciences will be not the exploit and manipulate nature and bring it under the short-sighted interests of human beings, but cooperate with it. The key of new era will be cooperation with nature leading to synthesis. This task will be in the hands of musicians. Future scientists will find out that the nature of the man arranged by the soul, which for ages conditioned them. Once the composer discovers the combination of sounds that will be able to penetrate into the centers of head, which control the genes, then long life on earth will be possible. The future of humanity can be very bright if greed and separatism don't destroy the planet. Okay. Thank you, sir, for this given opportunity, and thanks for coming.